Special guest, Tess is on the stream.
hot 5 minutes.
Tess is like
ice tea.
She's like one of those singers.
Your thing.
Gonna be.
I got it.
Hold on. She's like one of those singers. And like,
after the slap.
You remember those?
Yes, yeah, after the slap.
Don't pull a muscle.
I want to see a slap first. I want to see entertainment first.
It's not entertainment.
It's not.
Nope. It is
entertainment. Robert, will you stop stretching? Oh my god.
Robin is stretching.
Is this readable for you guys?
That's super
totally
readable.
Readable.
Yes.
Why can't read this?
Get his ball.
You
need to lead, not to read.
Oh, yeah. See, I can't do that. We can't ever do this. Like, this has already started.
Wait, I can't. Where's the thing?
This is what's
going.
Oh, we can't see. This is the chat. Okay,
wait.
I
don't have it. I put it in my room.
Oh my god.
It's dead. My phone's dead.
Ask people to get out.
But yeah, we are
with my feet
starting the stream now.
Yes.
It's already started.
Are we started?
We're back.
Yeah.
Okay,
we're back.
And we're back.
Yeah.
We're back, and we haven't gotten more professional since last time.
Wait, where are we back from? Where are we back from?
E3.
Back from E3,
not
and
me.
Apparently you being sick, and...
Yes.
Wait, you got sick at E3?
No, I was sick prior to going to E3.
Oh.
And then
we didn't have a
pre-E3
show.
Yeah, we
were...
We're double recording. That's Tess's voice, you guys hear.
It's time for Robin to slap the shit out of Peter.
If you can't hear that,
you all enjoy.
The reason this is called
Robin,
Slap 16 is because Robin and Pete made a slap bet over who wins the NBA Finals. Peter bet for the Warriors, Robin for the Cavs. And of course, the Warriors lost.
So Robin's got to now use the power of his calves to slap Pete.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
To slap him like a warrior.
Yes. I like that.
Like warriors do. Because warriors slap each other.
I hope this was a friendly slap right now, man.
I don't
it's
going to
be
so,
something that...
If you guys go on our Facebook page, you will see how Peter slapped Robin. And it's my favorite thing on the internet right now.
I'm making faces.
Who's gonna see it? Only our friends are gonna see it.
Yeah, I mean,
well, where can they see it?
They could direct the camera to.
Well,
to
are we gonna,
stream,
gonna
I mean.
Put it on our stream where you
but
get slapped too?
Can you put it on Instagram? On the Instagram, the Nerds Instagram?
Oh, you can put it on the Nerds Instagram.
Yes. So we'll put it on the Nerds Instagram later so you can see how Robin gets slapped.
Okay.
Shameless plug for the Nerds Instagram.
Yes. Follow us.
Follow us on Instagram.
Where is he?
So where did he go? Like,
the
who's doing the
bathroom? He get his, you know, fluid.
Is he wetting his hands?
We were supposed
he's
to.
He's probably wetting his hands for the slap.
Are you
I'm not
ready
sure.
with the slow-mo?
Who's gonna?
Let me get on it. Get on the slow-mo.
Yeah, get that slow-mo going because I want to get that on another Instagram.
You gotta get it.
I want the slow-mo
oh,
one.
The slow-mo slap was best.
The slow-mo slap for Robin was awesome. He's like, boo.
And that's why it's my favorite thing on the internet. Like,
it was so
it's
fucking great.
We're
gonna put
right
the video of
you
dancing just dancing
to
though, too.
We're not doing that.
I gotta see that.
Things
I have to see that.
Things we're not doing. So
that looks promising. That looks promising.
Tess is so excited.
I was gonna say let's start talking E3, but now he's back.
Now he's back. So
wait, we're doing this now. We're not ready now.
Who's gonna work that camera?
What do you mean you're not ready now? We're discussing this.
They can hear. The slap would be implied. I just want everyone to know that I'm against any kind of violence. So I know we're down this.
Here, I'll bring up OBS so I can see whether it's on him or not.
There you go.
Probably on him. You can watch from the stream thingy, right?
Yeah,
oh, okay.
I'm just saying,
you're gonna hear a reaction from me.
I just want
see his face on it?
Yes.
Yeah. Clearly.
You can see him clearly.
I just want everyone to know.
Guys, look at this.
That friends shouldn't slap friends.
I feel like we're sportscasting.
Here's Robin.
And he's stretching.
Here's Robin.
Oh, move the
as he's stretching to give the biggest slap.
Here's the wind up.
Can someone move
he's
the Chewbacca cup?
He's getting ready right now.
As Pete.
Don't be in the ring to slap.
As Pete, wait,
I feel like we're the
for
Spanish
this to be
announce table.
All right.
As you wait patiently until this day.
That's why everyone knows that I'm against it.
Don't miss. You only get one shot.
One shot, one kick.
You only get one shot. You stop the blow. You only get one opportunity.
Stretch a little bit back. Stretch a little bit back, and you should be good. Stretch a little bit back, you should be good.
Because then you're gonna see all
of,
like, I don't know where to stand now.
Wobble, wobble. No one spit on me. Because I'm feeling like this. It's gonna be like a sword
right here. Oh, over there. Oh, you're righty.
Left! I'm gonna miss!
So we have a king? You turn to King Lawless?
This game slap is taking way too long, dude.
Yeah, it is.
You know what? It takes time.
The prep for the slap is too much.
There's a lot of pressure.
It's a lot of pressure, exactly.
I feel like Steph Curry and LeBron.
We do have it live on Twitch.
Pandemonium!
There are millions and millions of fans watching this.
What? Let's see the slap.
Millions! And millions! And the millions! All the nerds.
Alright, so you gotta answer this question before you do it.
Are you ready?
No.
Are you gonna cry?
I hope not.
Are you ready?
Oh, man. Guys, you're seeing great stuff right here.
Alright, this is the slap giving everyone for who is joining right now.
What is
getting ready to slap.
Gonna channel my inner Marshall Erickson.
What do the five fingers say to the face?
Slap him in! Ready. Oh my god. Ready!
Oh,
man!
Oh,
man!
Oh! Oh!
Oh, man!
Whoa!
Oh, man!
Oh, my God. Are you fake red? Is your face red?
Oh, my God. It's so red! Look at that
pan.
Oh, my God. I can see it from here.
I'm so sorry.
Alright guys, you gotta hug it out. At least hug it out.
He did
alright.
Yeah. Oh,
my heart
is guilty.
You alright?
Oh,
what's a slap on Facebook?
Yo, he's tearing right now from one eye.
Okay.
Holy
okay.
Shit.
Yo.
I'm so sorry.
Wait, we can't curse, right?
No.
Thank you
no.
For okay. Joining.
All right. Holy
there.
That's
good.
That's
good.
Holy snipes.
That's
good. Oh my God. Yo, okay, so that happened. I'm looking at his eye right now, and it's really tearing up.
Alright, Steve, enough, Steve. Alright, cool. Alright, so let's get into the meat of the potatoes of the show. Now the slap is over.
Alright, so yeah.
Alright, so we have a special guest here with us this week. We're gonna let him introduce himself, tell what he does.
Oh!
Guys!
That was actually pretty deadly.
It was really good.
Okay. So Steve, take it away.
Sure, my name is Jay Kidd.
Alright,
so my name is Jay Kidd. I'm from Gamers With Attitude. I'm the founder of that show on YouTube. You can subscribe to Jay Kidd is 973. Well, follow on Twitter and subscribe to GWA Gamers With Attitude. I do a lot of playthroughs with Jay Kidd Just Plays and just Gamers With Attitude. And pretty soon we're doing reviews. So make sure you guys check that out. Definitely.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. So we're gonna get into this week's episode of Nerds of the Realm. As you heard prior to the slap, we just got back from E3.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
So we played a lot of games. We got a lot of hands on with things that are there. We did a lot of cool things. I think where we're out in LA that we want to talk about. So I don't know if you want to start with Game of Thrones or you just want to jump into the E3 stuff.
We can jump into the E3
stuff.
Yeah,
jump into E3. What I thought would be interesting to start off with was there were two pieces of hardware that were announced at the press conference from Microsoft.
Yes.
I was wondering how you guys felt about that one.
Well, I feel like the Xbox One S, I think it is.
Yeah.
It looks like a PS4 a little bit.
Almost. Like, it's a slight difference. It's just now with this one, it has a 4K resolution.
It's 4K resolution for video.
Oh, okay.
So you can stream 4K from Netflix, because they have that on there, and then you can, if you have like 4K movies, stuff like that, you can watch it on there.
Yeah,
you can't play games in 4K on that one.
Now,
unfortunately.
I don't have an Xbox myself, so I wanted to pick up that Xbox. But it's in white, and I'm hoping it comes in other colors.
Mm-hmm.
Someone
told
me
it's going to be white.
Someone told me they saw a gray one.
They lied. I think they lied.
That's probably a lie.
It might have been the white one in a dark room.
That's probably a lie.
But, hopefully it'll come out in other colors besides white. What would you guys game of show? Like, what blew you away if you had to pick one?
Oh, we glossed
through
that. I'm sorry?
So we just glossed through that. Or these guys are talking about how they felt about it.
Well, what games did you think was game of?
I don't know.
You weren't blown away by anything?
Not too
weren't
much.
Excited?
I'm just excited for Sea of Thieves.
Just okay. The,
but I don't even know how it plays.
Yeah,
just
we didn't get a chance to play it.
No. I don't even know what it's about. I just know that you're a bunch of pirates and then you're...
I saw that game. It was in the Microsoft
section.
I grazed past it. I didn't actually play it myself. For me, a game that I liked in the art direction of a game that I liked was Cuphead. I know Greg's not too crazy about it.
No.
It's a platformer. It feels a little bit like Contra to me.
Did you play it?
I played it.
You liked it?
I liked it.
I played it too. I did not like it.
Seeing from gameplays, I really like the animation onto the game. I mean, it has that old cartoonish feel, definitely. And it looks challenging, and I would love to play that game. Definitely.
Yeah, see, I love the art style of it. Before I actually got a chance to play it, I was totally down for this game. Like, you can ask Pete too. Like, we talked about how we're gonna be playing that as soon as it comes out. But playing it, I have a little bit of hesitation now because there are a couple of things in the game that make it really difficult to see what's going on. And because of that, it becomes frustratingly difficult. And not difficult in like a Mega Man or like an actual platformer kind of difficult. It's difficult in they swarm the screen with enemies and they die, they explode into a puff of cloud, puff of smoke and stars. And you can't see anything.
I was gonna say, I know one of your complaints was that the animation blends in too well. I fought a boss that was like, I want to say it was a carrot, and then it starts crying, and the tears start coming down, and it has red tears, blue tears. And with the animation, someone said something.
That's Ricky. Ricky.
Okay.
It's a week.
A week.
It's called a week wrong.
Can't spell. It did blend and make it hard to see with the tears coming down. So I do understand.
Yeah, and there were a couple other people that had the same complaint. So I'm not the only one out there. So I'm not saying this game is really difficult.
Greg's hating
so
on this game just because he doesn't like it.
I've been playing Mega Man recently, and I really love those games. They're very difficult games, but they're difficult because of the way the game was made, not because of how things look on it.
Yeah,
and I think that's either a cheap way to make a game more difficult, or it's something that an oversight that they missed and didn't really think about yet.
Maybe they do see it, which is why.
Which is why it's been
it's taking
so long.
Yeah, how long? It's been like 3 years, three straight E3s that we've seen it.
The game
and the game was playable at like all three.
Was it?
I think so. Yeah, I know it's been playable for like at least the last 2 years.
It just needed, I don't know.
They've been in development for a long time, and
it's indie, right?
Yeah, it's definitely an indie game. And the most interesting thing I saw on it was super moves. You get to do super moves on bosses or any random time. I think those were a little creative. Yeah, it just it comes out of their head when they're spinning or something like that. So I seen that in the preview. Didn't know if they have it in the actual gameplay section of it, but. Yeah, I thought it was interesting too that you can at least have a chance to survive on that game. So
I was also blown away by the gameplay of Days Gone.
That's the zombie one?
The zombie one with Sam Witwer as the protagonist.
Right.
I love the fact that they showed us at the Sony press conference one way to play it. But then when you go into that room that they had, the guy played it a completely different other way.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So you got to see two aspects of the way you could play the game. And like the zombie count made it feel like World War Z.
Yeah.
Like the way you'll be shooting like a stack of them and some will come out a window. And,
yeah. It looks like a flute. The zombies look like water.
Yeah.
They do.
They're flowing.
They're coming at you just like that. And like there's parts where he climbs under like a low train, and the zombies have to find a way around it. And,
another.
I think it's actually kind of funny that they haven't done a game like that yet, where there are zombies just like a massive horde just coming.
And they're running. They're not like this slow.
I don't think there has been a game like that. Right?
Well, Last of Us has running zombies.
Yeah, they have running zombies. They have running zombies in Resident Evil, the remake, the original Resident Evil remake.
Mm-hmm.
That game had the Crimson Heads. They never had it to such a degree as Days Gone, where they're actually like a horde of zombies chasing you down.
Do you think people are tired of zombies?
I wouldn't say that. The E3 was flooded with zombies. There was that game, Dead Rising 4, Resident Evil, another Resident Evil with zombies. So zombies are still like...
But Dead Rising and Resident Evil already established. Why do we need a third one?
Yeah, not only that, but Sony's already got Last of Us, which is definitely coming back for a sequel.
Yeah, right?
I'm surprised that wasn't there.
I'm not.
No.
My dog takes time with those games.
I feel like they're taking that to another direction, though, mostly. With the fungus disease or anything like that, they're probably going to do something a little bit more intense than that, let's say.
The zombies?
Well, yeah, they have to make the second one better than the first.
Yeah,
and
so
it's hard to top that.
Sequel,
so.
Mostly. The most that I liked about the game he was talking about is the
Days Gone,
is that when you go to like a craft your gun, mostly you can use a filter of a car.
Oh,
you can shoot the
silencer
on
that. I know,
it's
pretty cool.
That was pretty cool.
Even though they didn't use it much.
Yeah, exactly.
Awesome.
But that shows that you have more creative things to create. You know, any weapons that you can create onto it.
There were some creatures also in the game that weren't zombies. They were like these tiny, like, they look like almost the things from Castlevania, the Hunchbacks.
Yeah.
Kind of.
Mm-hmm.
They had those characters in it.
Well, technically, they're saying that all the creatures aren't zombies. They're called, like, freakers or something.
Oh, they're not zombies.
They're technically not zombies. But everyone fucking does that.
Yeah, exactly.
They're like,
they make all
these
names.
Aren't zombies, they're walkers. Oh, these aren't zombies, they're whatever.
The more they work on that game, it's going to be one of those games that you will want to watch and keep up with.
Yeah, and it's Ben. Sony Ben has done some really good stuff. They did the whole Siphon Filter games. They did the Uncharted game on the Vita, which is really good.
Yes.
So that
game was good.
Yeah. Looking forward to that. As far as things that I saw that I liked, I thought Sea of Thieves looked awesome. Got to see Bloodstained in action. And that was pretty cool.
Which one is that?
That's the Castlevania kind of game.
Oh, I don't know.
By Koji Igarashi.
Mm-hmm.
We
were actually talking about this before.
Yeah, we were talking about this before on the stream. And that game looks awesome.
Mm-hmm.
It looks totally Castlevania-esque, which is great after the disappointing Mario number 9.
Oh, yes. Don't even talk to me about that.
we don't go into that.
Nah.
But besides that, I really like the new direction of God of War.
Let's talk God of War.
Let's talk God of War then.
Was there a demo there?
There was one demo.
Only one, probably. I heard.
So that's probably, of the big exclusives Sony's announced, that's probably the furthest away.
And that was the first one.
2017?
Yeah, I think either late 2017 or early 2018.
So what I'm gathering from...
Besides, what's his name? Kojima's game. That's fucking way off into the future.
Yeah, exactly.
So what I'm gathering from 2018. God of War... It's a complete reboot
like
of the series.
What do you mean it's a reboot?
It's not a reboot.
Instead of the reboot,
it's
of
not
the
a
series.
Reboot.
No.
Who said?
The fact.
Yeah, it's not
no,
a reboot. So what,
definitely
it's,
not.
What they said, what I heard them say, which is really, really bad, they said it's a reimagining, which makes it sound like it's a reboot. And it's not. It's a continuation of the God of War story. So you see Kratos already has the ash from his old family still on him. And he's got the Spartan Rage. Those are things that carried over from the last trilogy. So this is, they said that in an interview later, they said that the first three games, well, all the five games, if you count the PSP stuff.
Yeah.
six, because of the other game, whatever. The past games have been Act 1 of Kratos' story. This is going to be Act 2. So it's a continuation, a progression of where he left off. So now he's left Greek mythology. He's left Greece.
He disappeared.
There's no one else to kill. He goes to Scandinavia and tries to start anew, which is pretty cool, I think.
I like the way that they're taking it to make his son learn everything.
By the way,
before
you get too far into it, GLJG says new set.
Yes,
we have a new set.
Are you talking about the dishes?
We stayed in California. We're in Hollywood Studios.
Yes. All the way here just to be in the show.
We've gone Hollywood.
We've gone Hollywood now. But yeah, go on.
The direction that they're taking for God of War. I like that they're basically teaching the ways of how Kratos were and to his son, and you know he shows a little sympathy, a little bit, but didn't want to. as you saw in the trailer.
Yeah, yeah.
But, you know, he didn't want to,
I love,
you know,
the
little, be a little...
the little touch they had where his, like, Spartan Rage meter fills up.
Oh,
and
yeah,
gets
that's
added.
True. That's awesome. I think that was wonderful, I think. But, yeah, with that and the new... I see new mechanics on it, too, as well. And what about that axe that he had?
Oh, the axe
cool.
was cool.
The
oh.
axe was
Were you, like,
amazing.
Called it back to him?
Yeah, exactly. Some Jedi Force Kratos has? I don't know.
Yeah. Glad to see anger management classes working for Kratos. Didn't even kill his son. Shot him. Good dad. Good dad indeed.
Yeah.
We did not... I didn't see Mario Lopez. Did you see him?
I didn't see Mario Lopez.
Mario Lopez.
Not that I was looking for Mario.
Kratos was about to, like, go crazy on his son, right?
Yeah.
And then kind of calmed down
meter,
a little
like,
bit.
Went up a little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah. I thought I loved the new direction for it, and at first I was even like 2 weeks ago when we had a stream, I was like, I hope it's not Kratos in the game because I don't really care about Kratos. And then we watched the trailer and I was like, I kind of care about Kratos right now.
And then a lot of people cared about Kratos after that night.
Yeah.
Do you think they'll kill him?
It's possible.
Maybe.
But I doubt it after them saying it was act two of his story. So I think there's probably an act three.
Oh, okay.
So I don't think they're gonna kill him just yet.
I think his son will take over the aggression.
I'm all for rebooting the series and changing everything, but I didn't think they had to change T.C. Carson as the voice.
You're just not a fan of change, are you?
He's not a fan of change.
I'm not. Don't make Link jump and don't change Kratos' voice.
Don't make Link jump.
Yeah, they put a jump
by
Zelda.
We discussed
this. That's gonna be another discussion.
We'll talk about
that.
When
I push that jump button, and I turned to that guy, I was like, he just jumped when I hit this button. He goes, yeah, we changed it.
So
like,
I don't care that T.C. Carson isn't Kratos in this.
No?
Don't care at all. Because I did not care for his character before. I didn't give a shit. Because he was the dude that yelled all the time.
Yeah, all he did was grunt. And
he grunted and screamed. Yeah, that's his entire...
But Kratos was built on the rage that he has for his father.
Yeah, but anyone can do that.
But now he's not a rageful monster.
That's true.
Monster.
Anybody can do that.
Yeah.
I hate you.
Now he's not a rageful monster.
So what's his... Why is he fighting for... What's he fighting for now, man?
Now he has lines.
Well, now
he has responsibility.
He can be an identifiable character.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, I've heard some different rumors and things like that. Where I've heard that it's not Kratos now, that it's Odin.
It's Kratos.
And the son is Thor because he uses lightning.
Yeah.
To fight the other, and he doesn't call. He never says his son's name in the trailer. He just calls him boy.
So.
Also, there's a part when the kid runs further away. If you look, you can see Loki floating behind him.
Yeah, so people are saying that's Loki, right? Which may be true.
Okay.
Technically, in Norse mythology, Loki is his uncle, technically.
Mm-hmm.
But also in that trailer, in the very beginning of it, there's the kid playing with two wooden figures, smashes them together, and says, "Your hammer doesn't scare me." It's probably a Thor figure, which means Thor already exists in that world.
That doesn't have to be true, though.
I think so.
It could be a Cyclops with a hammer. That Cyclops had like the.
I mean, it could be any guy with a hammer.
Also,
and then like that becomes the inspiration.
I think that would be. I think that would be cool.
I think besides that, though,
if that was true,
his lightning powers could come from his grandfather Zeus.
That's true. Yeah.
Good point, Greg.
Yeah.
But if they did take it the route that, you know, that the rumor mill is, I think that would be amazing.
Or maybe his mother is a god.
Well, they have a lot to play with, so
it
goddess.
Yeah.
Goddess. It'll be interesting to see what Sony does.
I thought it had like a Last of Us feel for God of War.
Thor's hammer was made before Thor was born, so then that would mean
Odin's
exists
hammer
in the world too.
So
like even if it was Odin using the hammer, that would mean he exists in the world, which means Kratos can't be Odin, and that's obviously Kratos.
Mm.
Like sure. it could be possible that Kratos becomes the inspiration for Odin throughout the game. I'm not saying that's not possible, but he's obviously Kratos. He's not a different character.
Okay, we'll see. We'll see when it comes out. But any other games that stood out to you guys that
Well, I guess
Forza.
Well, I guess
I did play Forza.
Tekken 7.
I played Forza. Forza.
Oh, did you play Forza?
Yeah. I had a lot of fun with it, actually.
Did you see that card thing out there on that little rotating thing?
Oh, yeah.
The Lambo?
Yes.
I actually was talking to, when I talked to Vince in Genito, I'm going to play this one on the PS4, the Neo. Let's not get into that right now. Neo wasn't announced at E3. We don't need to talk about it now either. but yeah, I was talking to Vince in Genito about that. And he said that he played Drive Club in VR with a headset in one of those chairs.
That's awesome.
And it was like, how can you get more immersive than that? Like, there's probably no game out there that could be more immersive than that. And he said it was fucking amazing.
When you play at home, you're not going to have that chair, number one.
Of course not. But for the people that are willing to put in that extra money, you can have the full, like, racer experience.
$1,000 later.
Or you can just get your own car.
Yeah, that's true.
Or you can get your own car.
There you go. You want the experience?
It's more dangerous.
Yeah.
You can't rewind.
You want the
car.
You want the experience going really
Did anyone play, that's it. I always forget the name of it. The game with the girl and the robot dog.
Oh, no.
Recore.
Did anyone play that?
No,
that line was ridiculous, and it looks like trash.
Really?
I think it looks like trash. Okay. The game looks generic as hell.
I'm iffy on it, too. Yeah. Especially since, who's on it?
Keiji Inafune again. And
so that's a huge red flag.
And I think some of the people from Retro Studios, the guys that did Metroid.
So that's like the counter to Inafune on it.
Yeah. Record's going to be $40 in play anyway. Yeah, I think, I wonder about that, like the $40 thing.
What?
Like, I wonder if they like didn't feel that it was
worth 60.
Worth 60?
Probably. It's probably only single player.
I'm not. I think
it's
that was
probably
a big thing.
Short single player.
You got a follower here, guys.
Hey, nice. Who
followed? Oh, it's Stacy.
I thought she was already following.
She was.
Oh.
Okay.
She
got followed. We got
follow us? I'm hurt.
It's okay. We've been gone for like a month.
We've been abusing our power.
That we have.
Did you guys? I felt like
I saw the line for that, and I was just like, no fucking way.
I felt like a lot of games were like play through Xbox or Windows.
Yeah, which I think was...
Well, yeah, that's their new focus.
Yeah they're focusing
Xbox,
on
Xbox. If you buy it for Xbox One, you get on Windows, and probably vice versa.
Which I think they're hoping most people buy a laptop, and then can play it on their laptop on the go or something.
It just means more people will get Windows 10 or something. It'll help with overall sales for everything.
Mostly in competition with Steam or something like that.
Well, no, I think it's kind of cool that you can play...
Crossplay
with that, too.
Yeah,
that is cool.
That
is good.
Like, I plan on building a PC soon.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll probably put Windows 10 on it so I can do the crossplay with the Xbox and everything.
You know, what's crazy? There is some games that are crossplay now, like Killer Instinct for one.
Yeah.
There is one. Rocket League is another. Yeah,
yep.
Definitely. And
Gigantic
Street Fighter as in
PS4,
PlayStation
Gigantic
4 as
on Xbox.
PC. Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And it's pretty cool how they're doing this now, but the connectivity issue is probably what's keeping them back.
Minecraft. That'll be huge.
Yeah, that
oh,
can
yeah,
be huge.
Yeah. Minecraft would be huge
mm-hmm.
if it's
VR was a big thing at GC3.
Did you play any VR?
It's basically the year of VR.
Did you play any VR? Pete,
no.
You didn't get to do it.
No.
Not only were the lines like kind of crazy.
Well, they didn't have lines. They had the experience.
Oh, they had the experience thing. Like,
yeah.
I had the app too. Yeah,
yeah.
I don't.
Did you see they're doing Experience PlayStation this weekend? There are GameStops and Best Buys in the area are having the VR set up there.
That's cool.
That's cool.
Oh, that's
really
cool.
So, Ali Store actually
is gonna have it.
That's awesome.
And there's a Best Buy on 17 that's gonna have it too.
Do they know what demos
what
is
that,
coming
that
to?
Eve Valkyrie's gonna be there. Headmaster.
Mm. Eve Valkyrie could be cool.
I really want to play Eve Valkyrie.
If it's Batman, it's not worth it. Like, don't play Batman.
Drew said Batman VR was great.
Batman basically sets you up. You're in the Batcave. You put on the suit. You throw a batarang. You go to a
hip hop. You can come try the Rift at my house.
Okay, there you go.
Try out
the Rift.
Boom. I had a friend that was getting the Rift too.
You finally got it, huh? It took him like months to get this fucking.
He actually got it. It was like
$700.
He actually got it right before he went to Disney. They couldn't play it.
Yeah, nice.
Nah.
But the VR experience of waiting in line to try out VR. I hope they have like a VR game.
Actually,
I was
going to
say that would be
funny.
Awesome if you put the helmet on and you're in the line.
My friend got an early Rift kit, uh-huh. and there was one demo on there that was, whatchamacallit, being in a movie theater. So you put it on, you'd be in a movie theater, there'd be a movie screen, and then you could put on, like, a TV show or a movie.
So that's really cool. That sounds really silly to me right now, yeah. but,
I think they started
like,
doing that.
Say... I'm here in New Jersey. Say they got a friend in like California. We want to see a movie together. We could put on our headsets and have that experience.
It is kind of cool.
So it opens up some new possibilities.
Yeah.
Well, I got this Samsung Oculus. You guys know about
the Samsung Gear?
That is, yeah, that's Gear that's compatible
with your
phone.
Yeah, they had demos for that at E3 too.
I have that at home. So I experienced like a program called Sideload. Sideload basically is third-party apps that you can put onto your VR. So once you put that, you can put like your computer games onto it, like Resident Evil or any PC games that you can stream off to that. Now, I had experience with that, and it's pretty good, but it has a little connectivity or something. You see lag or some frame rates drop or anything like that. But
I think the Gear is the lowest end
if you want to start off
working VR, except for a Google Cardboard. I think that was
that's
absolute bother. That's cardboard. It's just like $50. It's actual cardboard.
I didn't even bother with that. That's
a harmless man.
Yeah, that's actual
exactly.
cardboard. I think it's actually less than that. But the PSVR is kind of like the mid-tier one.
Look at that. And Gear VR has made Minecraft.
Oh, that's interesting.
Mm-hmm.
What, Minecraft?
I think Minecraft would work really well on VR.
I might try that out. Thank you.
That'd probably be fun.
I guess. And then there's going to be that... what's the Microsoft one?
Oh, the what's
the
it called? The HoloLens.
HoloLens. Oh, HoloLens.
There we go.
HoloLens.
What did I
say? Sorry, people.
Good night, everybody.
Good night, everybody. I'm out. That's it.
They should have called the HoloCast.
The HoloCast. All
right, so.
All right,
so that was terrible on my part. Apologies.
John Carmack,
so there.
Report for NS. All right, cool.
Custom controllers.
Custom
Xbox controller.
So how did that work?
That's
when you go to their site.
You go to their site. You can choose the color for the like the front of the body, the back of the body, the bumpers and the triggers.
I think the battery pack you can do a separate color too, right?
That's with the back.
I mean, I checked it out.
Is
and
it
you
the
could,
same price as a holodeck?
It's more. Because they're making one specifically for you
so
and not making a whole line. It goes up to like 100.
For one controller?
For one controller.
Can you engrave anything on it? Or
yeah, you can engrave.
Laser engrave on there.
Okay, cool. That's cool, man.
I'd say it's a fair price. How much is a normal controller?
Like 60 bucks.
Yeah.
It's 60.
The
and
price of a
those
game.
Are, yeah. Those are mass produced. This is custom. I'm sure they like print out a bunch of variations and a couple thousand of each, but still.
Probably the only thing that's
I went to
not,
the website and they,
those
they
controllers
actually,
also have
colors. Which?
Oh, yeah.
The custom controller.
Yeah, so the Xbox One S
will come with
a Bluetooth controller too, which is slightly different. It's like, it's got a slightly different build to it too. It's kind of weird. But yeah. The Xbox One S will come with that.
Oh, yeah, we didn't talk about the Scorpio. They're not much to talk
about.
They're
not much to talk. They just announced that.
Yeah.
They just announced it.
Yeah.
It's going to be 4K.
Yeah. If you saw there was an interview with Phil Spencer after that. And he said, if you don't have a 4K TV, it's not going to do much for you right now.
But so. I feel like they'll do something that'll make it a must-have.
Yeah, they are a little bit smaller than the new controllers.
I can see 4K TVs lowering the price now. Yeah, because there's going to be a lot of people that they're...
Everyone's
going to
hop
off
with
it. Eventually,
exactly.
It happens with technology. They're going to lower the price.
Yeah,
which
by next year,
I think
by
having,
next year, they will probably, yeah.
Having 4K support in these new systems is a smart idea, because these things are going to come down.
They're eventually. Probably going to put VR on the TVs, basically, with the TVs.
Well, they're
TVs coming out
now,
though.
And
based
then
off
you
the,
see, like, the experience
based off
your
the 3DS.
No, in that interview, in the long interview that he had, he said it's not going to increase the power of 1080p games and make them better. So if you don't have a 4K TV, it's not going to help.
Yeah.
So what else did you guys? There was a lot to see in a short time. We can talk
about
Zelda.
Yeah, how about we
talk
about
Zelda?
Let's go to
Zelda. And his jumping.
I don't want to talk
about
it.
Why do you not like the jumping?
Because he's
off
a
the
fool.
Bag right
because
there.
He doesn't like change.
No, because I'm
he's
a fossil.
A
there you go. I'm a fossil.
It's because you're an old man.
It is. It truly. Like I. So we went to the room.
Mm-hmm.
First of all,
it's one cancer.
So, like, why?
Why?
What
do you think? That's what Scorpio considered the Xbox One cancer.
Like Scorpio.
So I didn't get to play Zelda to the last day because of how ridiculous the line was. The first day the line was closed. At 10:05, I think. The guy shut it down. Second day, I think you guys got out and got to play it.
Yeah.
And then the third day, we made it a priority to go there first and get in line. Did you guys see that video of everyone coming in on the third day going to the Zelda?
Yeah. That's how it was the second day.
The stampede? Did you see the stampede?
We saw it live in the second day.
I was part of it.
There was a person.
He was part of it.
Oh, you ran in like that?
No, I walked.
No, he was like Simba with the Wildebeest.
Yeah. There was a person who came into the middle of the thing and just stood there with his arms out. Did you see that? It's so funny.
And then he got trampled. Like Jon Snow.
We're in line, and I swear to God, I'm like, what's that noise? And we turn around, and you just hear, boom. I'm like, what is that? And then you just saw, like, this guy in the middle, like, balled up. You just saw a sea of people, like, just consuming.
Have you ever been to San Diego Comic Con?
I haven't.
It's exactly like that.
That's horrible. How it is.
Every day.
Horrible. So that's kind of why I don't want
to
go there.
Instead of games to play, they go for, it's a stampede of people for the exclusive toys and stuff like that.
Horrible, dude. I've never seen anything like that in my life. It's like,
what a San Diego is definitely still fun, though. I suggest going.
Oh, okay.
Everyone needs to go at least once.
Yay.
You still I feel like doing what
I
you did.
I don't want to.
No, you should.
I feel like
it's
doing,
still fun.
I feel like doing what you did where you don't have a ticket, you just go spur of the moment and try and just get in. But there's so many off-site.
If you have a connection,
but there's so many off-site things that you can do that it doesn't matter.
Yeah, they have a whole street, like, dedicated, not dedicated, but themed around Comic-Con.
Yeah.
Because not much goes on in San Diego aside from that. So, like, once a year, it just gets populated with all these nerds like us. Mm-hmm. And so the bars and the restaurants will, like, put themed drinks or food items on their menu. It's pretty cool.
So he's asking if we heard that someone stole the Zelda demo by dumping on an SD card. I thought he tried this.
Someone stole it?
Really?
I thought he didn't get away with it.
Wait, I didn't hear that.
I think I saw it somewhere.
I don't see how that would be possible. That
sounds hard to do.
There were like
everyone
people
had,
like dude.
Yeah, everyone like always had someone with them.
I had a person doing the demo with me, but he kept on looking at the other person.
Mm-hmm.
So I was pretty much unsupervised when I was playing.
Oh. The TV would have been black if you did something.
Like, you would have been out of the game if something...
Yeah, I'm pretty sure he didn't get it.
What's this, Sonic Team?
Sat down with... Oh, damn.
We got Sonic Team or developing completely. Oh, okay. Who cares?
Yeah, I didn't see anything from Sonic.
Who cares? Did you see the shade that's
the
that
animation
Sonic the Hedgehog
Sonic
threw at,
Twitter?
At fucking Mario Never Died.
That's pretty funny.
We were talking about Zelda, though.
Yeah, let's talk about.
He
so,
was like this.
So I started playing it third day. The first thing I noticed was the new jump thing. So I instantly turned around to my handler. That's what I call the person.
Okay, yeah, we'll call them handlers.
They're handlers.
Okay, cool.
So I turned to him and I go, oh man, I go, Link jump. He goes, yeah, that's a new feature that they added. Like they added a jump button.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, but he used to run and just jump by himself. And he goes, yeah, we want to change it up a little bit, whatever. Fine.
For the climbing.
Fine. All right. I'm running over, like, just certain things in the world, because the world is huge. And every time I run over something, it says, I think it's just, like, pick up or, like, what's it say when you want?
Yeah, like, pick up, loot it, or something.
Yeah, it said something. So I felt like, I picked up, like, 1,000 sticks. I picked up, like, I jumped in the air and caught an apple out of the tree. It just felt like...
Too much?
It wasn't too much. It felt like I was just doing pointless stuff.
I feel like it might be too much.
Have you ever played
RPG?
Yeah. Dude, I played Final Fantasy. I played Kingdom Hearts.
But no, I mean like Skyrim.
But I think or the RPG. So I think my problem is that the RPGs that I played are, what do you call it when they
linear.
Linear. Like they have you on a path.
Okay.
Zelda's so big that you can get lost in the world.
Yeah. Just, that's what they want you to do.
That's,
yeah.
That's basically what.
So
yeah,
that's
what
probably
the
with the.
Final Fantasy
isn't a real RPG.
Whoa.
I'm gonna ignore that. We're just gonna move on.
Well, but I feel like...
Objection.
Ban her.
Yes. They actually had a little stand there. That would have been cool to do in that little stand.
Every time he says something that we don't like, like, what did it say, overruled or something? Or which one is it, overruled or sustained?
Well, overruled.
Overruled.
I don't think he likes Final Fantasy. Final Fantasy is a Western RPG or Eastern?
Eastern.
Eastern? It's a Japanese RPG. Role-playing game, yes.
Okay.
And Japanese role-playing games follow the same formula that Final Fantasy does. So
there's no role-playing.
Technically, you're role-playing in every single game that you play.
Well, Final Fantasy to me is like, it feels like a linear where you're like,
yeah.
So that's probably why I don't think of like Zelda like that. I feel like Zelda's more like, more towards Grand Theft Auto now, where I can start playing the game, and then like if I don't want to do the mission, I can just wander off over here.
Yeah, I feel like that's the feel that they're going for.
Yeah, that's what they're going for.
But it's a huge world, like it's crazy.
Yeah.
Well, it doesn't feel like a task anymore, because on the past Zelda games, you felt like you were doing a task for other people. When you have to complete something, you just want to feel like you want to explore this area over here. You want to explore everything, like dungeons or anywhere that you can go. And from that, you can... Hold one sec.
But in all seriousness, I like the Mass Effect Andromeda trailer. Almost tempts me to get a new console. Hopefully they'll re-release it. So if you like that little bit of Mass Effect they showed, that tiny bit, at the awful E3 EA press conference... My God, that was by far the worst.
We should talk about like the.
Do you want to talk about the press conference?
The things that we thought were lackluster.
Yeah.
Because EA is lackluster. The worst press conference there. If you liked what you saw there, check out the Mass Effect Andromeda leak. Because there's a couple of leaked. It's a little leaked footage. There's actually footage of like animations and things.
It's really alpha.
It looks really good, but it's really alpha. It's like. Way not close to done.
Well, I didn't like the fact that Zelda was the only game that Nintendo had.
Yeah,
it was bad.
Pretty much.
Like, I love their booth though.
Their booth was fucking beautiful.
The booth was amazing.
It was pretty
but
much
like
bad
for they had like someone told me they had like 200 demos.
What? Like, of the same game.
Yeah.
Well, 200 stands that you can go play at.
Yeah, probably.
But it felt like the line went forever.
Well, yeah, because that doesn't.
Well, it was two demos.
It's probably
like,
people. Yeah. It's 100. I mean, they had demos there for, you know, us lining up. They had one for press, which is up in the...
Yes.
Like, the stairs up.
They had the VIP area.
Yeah.
I saw that up top.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think they had 100.
They was like close to 200.
And there was also the booth right next door, like all the way in the corner, right behind the Nintendo booth. That was for press or whatever.
Okay.
Yeah. Did you
maybe
do you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Maybe they counted that.
It's the other side.
And they did a little presentation thing before you get to play the game, which kind of slowed it up too.
That slowed it down a lot.
Yeah, that was unnecessary. I thought it was unnecessary.
Yeah.
But they want to make it, you know, a big production.
Yeah.
Welcome to the new world. In fact, when did they change the title to Breath of whatever?
They announced it for the first time there.
It never had a title.
Okay, because I was like, when they were like, oh, it's a Breath of whatever. I'm like, where did it come from?
Zelda's last real game they're making that isn't for the NX, and the NX isn't announced yet, so there was nothing they can do. Actually, the NX was announced.
Well, they announced that it exists. They didn't announce the actual thing.
And they had those new Pokemon games that they're coming out
with.
Yeah.
They could have had those playable.
I really feel like they should have said something about the NX.
There's also another Monster Hunter, where I got the Monster Hunter Generations, which I got the demo for in an email while I was at E3. So they could have had that there.
I actually gave a giveaway like last week on that.
Yeah, so like they could have had Monster Hunter.
There you go.
Yeah.
What was the weirdest thing game you guys saw at E3? So we touched on VR a little bit ago, but the weirdest game I played at E3 was a game called Headmaster. Which was a lot of fun. It's a VR game. So I managed to register for standby at the Sony VR thing. I played that game. It's basically a soccer game mixed with Portal. Because you have like this disembodied voice making fun of you as you're playing the game. And basically telling you about this thing like it's a science experiment. You have to head the ball. You can't kick or anything. You have to head the ball into the goal and hit different targets and stuff. So that was weird and it was fun.
The weirdest thing I saw was the Naughty America VR booth.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
And the crowd of people.
Are we talking about that?
Well, that, I'm just saying
sure.
That.
Okay.
That's
did
it.
You, did you do it?
I didn't
no,
do
I
it.
I didn't do it.
I didn't see that.
I heard that demo is really weird.
Some people playing the VR, like, I feel like VR is something you should do at your house because you look weird.
Playing
anyway.
Outside,
but like to do it in public, like there's some videos out there.
But you're among people who are like expecting that. And
are you gonna watch?
I understand that, but like I saw people recording people and laughing while they're recording. So I know that's gonna end up somewhere on YouTube or.
Well, they're probably their friends. Like, look at the IGN.
No, it wasn't their friends. Like. First of all, they had stations where you could just walk by and just look at people playing. So, like, I saw people walking and they would just stop, you know, see the person doing something. Like,
I don't think the Oculus Touch controllers were there.
They were there.
They were there?
Yeah, they were there.
Okay, I didn't see that.
Did you go to the Oculus booth?
Oculus was like...
I remember seeing it.
There was the top floor, I mean the West Wing, right?
Yeah, and they were in the far corner.
And they were in the far,
okay. I don't think I saw them.
They were deep in the back of E3.
I did see
them and the Samsung people. They were all in like the same area.
Oh, yeah. Were they? I saw Samsung.
They were all. So
maybe,
I
missed
there
it.
Too, yeah.
Maybe I just missed it.
But yeah. Weirdest game that I saw. I don't think I've seen any weird games. Not that I remember.
Well, I'll add another one in there. Fate Stay Night has a Musou game. Fate Stay Night is an anime, and it's got like a Dynasty Warriors game.
Dynasty Warriors, yeah.
It's so weird.
Oh man,
they,
I don't know why.
How is that
in
VR?
Nintendo announced.
Oh, it was in VR. It was just regular.
Oh, I thought it was a VR game.
Nintendo announced a game from the people who made.
Keys to Hands-Free. So that's the problem with Naughty America VR, from what I've heard, is that it gives you no control whatsoever. So you're basically getting raped as you're
playing. You just look.
So you just start screaming.
There's no interaction.
Yeah, you just look. There's no interaction whatsoever. And then you're when the guys at IGN played it. So one of them was like, I'm this white guy with tattoos all over my arm. I'm completely jacked. And I have no idea who I am. And some girl comes in, like sits on his lap. And that's how things get started. And then the girl was playing it. And she was like, yeah, it felt very uncomfortable because I felt like I was getting raped.
Wow.
She played the girl version, which was just her like sitting there like this, and some dude just comes in and starts playing it. So,
you can tell how much she likes it.
It's so weird.
And she was like, "That was really uncomfortable." And they acknowledge that because they've had a couple of girls play it, and none of them like it. Not a single woman who's played the game has liked it.
Wow.
Let's talk about Last Guardian getting a date finally.
Yeah, when is it? I pre-ordered
October.
The Collector's Edition.
I have no idea
when the game is coming out.
October, I want to say
25th? 25th, I think?
I want to say
sure.
25th or 27th.
But it's about damn time.
Yeah, it is about damn time.
Yeah,
the game looks amazing.
It does.
By the way...
I'm not sure it looks amazing, but...
For me, it looks amazing.
It looks good with their style.
Yeah.
That's their style.
That's
game.
Their style.
Yeah.
Okay. But... I feel like there's no way that game lives up to expectations.
You think it's going to be horrible?
I think it's going to be good. It's just not going to be...
Right.
It has 9 years to live up to.
Yeah.
Because it's been in production for 9 years.
9 years and Ico and Shadow of the Colossus slowed up to.
Right.
Which
are
both fantastic games.
It came out fairly...
Was that kind of... Did they get to play it?
What? Giant Bomb was not...
Are you talking about Last Guardian or Naughty America?
Because Last Guardian didn't have a demo.
About Naughty America.
It may
a press demo?
It may
probably, yeah, probably behind doors.
Oh yeah, it was a press demo. I remember reading a Kotaku article saying the game is real.
Oh, we played it.
Yeah,
I remember that.
Okay.
They have to play Last Guardian, okay.
Oh, okay.
Okay, I'll check that out because I haven't seen any impressions of it yet.
I pre-ordered it because I'm hoping it'll be good.
I've never actually played
that.
A game by those developers.
I played Last.
Oh, you should play
Shadow of Colossus.
Shadow of Colossus.
I've seen it.
Ico is meh at this point.
Meh.
Oh, because of technology?
Shadow is better. Yeah. It's clunky as hell. And it's a giant escort mission.
Well,
I mean, it's okay.
Yeah.
It's okay.
Did you see the interactive wall that they had there?
That was that PlayStation experience, so I already...
Okay. I thought it was really cool.
Wait, what? Oh, the wall?
They had a giant...
with the monster in the gate.
In the barrel.
Yeah.
They said it fell every year of its 10 years, and it was clunky and slow.
Is it going to be a Mighty Number 9? Don't
say this. No, because it's not taking your money, man.
Don't say this.
Until you buy it yourself.
Yeah, oh my God. True. Don't say this. Let's talk about Last Horizon Dawn.
Horizon Zero Dawn.
Whatever. Let's talk about that.
I'm looking forward to it.
Why does it remind me of Heavenly Sword?
Because she has red hair and she...
Yeah, exactly. Like,
it's Heavenly Sword.
Like
it was a,
yeah, it exactly. Like,
well, has, like, I don't think Scalebound was there playable.
Scalebound wasn't there.
It was
there.
Not.
I don't
no.
think so.
I attacked the guy who made it.
I think that game's in trouble.
Scalebound?
Yeah.
Shut up.
I think so.
Did you see those headphones that
it's
they
not coming
had?
Out until 2017.
Wait, did you see the headphones?
Yeah, it was supposed to be this
the
year.
The Beats by Dre.
No, the one that the kid was playing, that was playing the demo had on. He had on the actual headphones.
Beats by Dre.
So I feel like the collector's edition with headphones.
Oh, so you want a $400 collector's
edition? Yes, I did. I want a $400 with the statue and the headphones that go on the statue.
Yeah, I'm not really thrilled by Scalebound.
I wanted to be. Last year, it looked pretty cool. This year, it's... I don't know.
You didn't like the multiplayer?
No.
No?
I don't know. It could be... I'll wait for it. Like, it could be a sleeper hit.
Scalebound.
Yeah. Who made it? You guys who did Bayonetta. Platinum. I love Platinum. So, they could do really well with this, but at this point,
Platinum is a very hit or miss studio.
I would rather them take their time with Scalebound, and Scalebound be an amazing experience. Then them to rush it, put out a horrible demo, and people rip it apart. And, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, I'd rather it be just an amazing game. So.
But Mighty Number 9 has now raised like those questions they're delaying it. Does that mean it's bad? Oh, they're delaying it again. Does that mean it's bad?
We're always talking about Mighty Number 9.
That's the new thing now. But like, if something gets delayed, you bring up Mighty Number 9.
It was Duke Nukem before. That's if you, Stacey,
you say
out.
You either say like okay well, take time to make the game better or you say oh shit another Mighty Number 9
but people were so upset that Mighty Number 9 wasn't out at the the demo and people put money into it and they were asking for more money and the game wasn't even out yet for another game
so there
were a bunch of problems with Mighty Number 9. I guess we're going to start talking about this now.
I guess I can be in that segment.
Because it started off as a completely different game, and then some community manager came in and made a lot of changes to that game. Like, a lot of her input went into the game.
Less frame rates, less... It's clunky. The controls
are
really clunky.
It looks like shit.
It does.
You have to shoot an enemy like 5 times and you dash into it.
And you dash into them. Which is a clunky system of doing. And it looks cool. At first, and then you keep doing it.
Exactly.
There's no variety in the enemies. They're all the same fucking enemy.
Yes, they're all the same. I literally took like 10 hours to that game.
They tell you how to beat each boss.
Oh, you played it?
Yeah, I streamed it last night.
You streamed it for 10 hours.
For 10 hours.
I listened,
trying to beat this game.
I listened to a
really
kind of funny
bad.
Talk about it because Colin Moriarty is a huge Mega Man fan.
Yeah.
And so I wanted to hear what he thought about
it. He hates it.
I hate it.
Well, he doesn't hate it. He says it's not a good game, but
it's not
necessarily bad. It's just mediocre.
The thing is, it is
that's
it
bad.
Is there on difficulty. That
is kind of worse than bad.
I know.
It is there on difficulty. It's just everything else is just. So
oh my
bad.
God, Bob Tackman! It's been so long.
Bob, what's up?
Don't embarrass me.
I'm looking for the light tonight.
Smashing.
It's because he has the light on.
I do. I have light on me.
So the pirate game, Sea of Thieves.
Oh, being in his
sea
dark
Thieves.
Area and his house.
So Sea of Thieves is a multiplayer.
It's a multiplayer pirate game.
Pirate game.
But it's like 5v5v5 apparently.
Yeah.
So that's kind of cool.
That is cool.
I watched the video for it.
It just looks like pure fun. Like it looks like it's supposed to be what a game is supposed to
I'm
be.
I'm hoping there's more to it than that.
Or if it's at a cheaper price point.
Steam sale.
Yeah.
It definitely needs to be at a cheaper price point.
You know what we need to play, actually? This was announced at during Ubisoft's conference. Mm-hmm. Trials of the Blood Dragon.
Yeah.
What is
that? Trials.
It's a single player. You know Trials?
That's a bike.
It's the dirt bike
game. Those games are so fun.
Multiplayer, it's really fun, too.
So what's the blood dragon?
Trials Fusion was pretty good too.
You remember Far Cry Blood Dragon?
Yeah.
It's,
oh, so it's there.
It's a single player trials game. Far Cry.
I feel like that game's a version of like kind of like Excite
Bike. Starts tomorrow.
Yeah, it starts tomorrow. Nice. It's gonna be rough.
I'm already poor.
Oh, the Steam sale.
I'm already poor, so I can't do that.
Oh, the Steam sale starts.
Yeah, Steam sale starts tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. Oh my god.
But I feel like that's the not the poor man, but I feel like that's the next evolution of Excite Bike.
Yeah.
So Mighty Number 9 is more of Steaming Number 2.
Yes, it is. Thank
that's
you.
That's a good one.
Steaming Number 2.
That was a good one.
I'm tweeting that later, so I made it up. So just so you
know. What were we just talking about, though?
Sea of Thieves.
We kind of transitioned the trials.
Yeah.
But I want to talk about Sea of Thieves more.
Okay.
So I want to play that game.
I really want to play it.
I really want to play it. I want to check out some gameplay, because I know a lot of people took video of the gameplay
yeah.
of that.
Yeah.
So I want to check that out.
Is that made by Microsoft Studios?
That's Rare.
It's Rare, which is owned by Microsoft. So.
Yeah, yep. Which is owned by Microsoft now.
Sadly.
Yeah. We'll see
this game.
We'll see what this is. They've been doing a bunch of Avatar shit before this. So.
I feel like this is a game that would have been great in the 90s. Which is what Rare is so good at.
Yes.
Yeah.
So
definitely.
Like, I feel like this could be. It could be
so many good games.
I'm interested. To see more because that game's way out.
Keep my eye.
I don't think it's coming out next year.
No, they already have a demo for it. I feel like it'd be next year.
I don't think so.
Apparently,
they've shown basically the same area in 2 E3s now.
For what?
For Sea of Thieves.
Was
that last year?
I don't even remember that.
They announced it. And they showed, like, that video of the guy running from the island onto the ship and doing all that shit.
Oh.
It's basically the same area.
Oh, I don't remember that.
Except they added multiplayer this time. So I don't think that game's anywhere close to being out.
A Rare game? This words don't usually add up. Is this your protégé? CCD Pro?
Yeah.
Don't think so.
Is that protégé? You got a protégé in the chat.
CCD protégé? That is why I think to play anywhere is a big deal. If I can buy Sea of Thieves and play it on my PC and Xbox One friends, and then Scorpio, all by just buying it once, that's amazing.
It is pretty
amazing.
That is pretty cool, actually.
So I had that problem with Nintendo where I bought The Legend of Zelda.
You are missing out, Bob.
Right. Yeah, okay. look up Sea of Thieves. Check out the
trailer.
Yeah,
the trailers,
check the trailer out from this past E3. And
I'm sure there's some gameplay videos out there, too.
Yeah, there are probably some people playing.
A lot of people are recording.
It just looks like a lot of fun.
Yeah. That was my problem with Nintendo. Is I bought The Legend of Zelda, the first one, for the 3DS. And then I thought, let me download it for my Wii, because I bought it already.
And it's like,
and they tell me that there's two different versions of it.
Yeah, you gotta buy it.
I had to call Nintendo.
But
like, how are you so far behind the times? I don't get it.
Here's the NX better have VR capabilities. I'm just saying. Otherwise, that's Nintendo being
honestly. You don't know that like a Blu-ray player
would be possible. I think NX is dead in the water already.
Right. Because
you have Neo and Scorpio coming out.
Yeah.
I think NX is dead.
I like the next system's names, Neo and Scorpio.
But those are just the project.
Those
names.
Are projects. Yeah.
I have to keep them.
I don't think NX does anything. I think it's gonna be a font like the
Wii
U. Wii
U is
a
project
terrible.
Name.
They're behind.
If the NX crashes, then Nintendo would have to just make games.
Make games for the PS4.
Yeah,
there's only one or two games that are.
They have a lot of money stocked up. They can fail a couple of times before they have to.
Yeah. Thanks, Wii.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, thanks.
Thank you.
They can afford failing. They would want to fail again.
See, if this is like Destiny, but with pirates.
Maybe. I don't know too much about
and how it is portable. See, the reason I say NX is dead is because they've been comparing the specs of it to the PS4 and the Xbox One.
And then the sign them are moving on to other
think that they're banking on making a good-looking system that has Nintendo games on it, but now they're no longer going to be a good-looking system when those systems come out.
Well, let's talk about Zelda for a second, because there were times in parts that I went to a Zelda where the graphics weren't that great.
Right.
But then again, you said it was the TVs and not the games. right? You said it.
I'm saying them. I said their monitors were shit.
Okay.
The monitors they had there for Zelda were absolute shit.
So you think that?
And to see that on, because you can see that the difference between.
But
that
do you
and
think that was a factor there. On the way the games look?
Also, yeah. No. I'm more worried about Zelda Breath of Wind because of the limitations of the Wii U.
Yeah.
Like you could tell playing on it. The draw distance, how much you're able to see of the environment, like all the way up into the mountains, it starts getting foggy. So you can't see that far. If it wasn't a more powerful system, which the NX could be, then you could see farther.
Also, I wonder if it was developed for the NX and then...
Yeah, exactly. So it's like if you buy it for the Wii U, you're not going to get like as much wow out of
Wind
than you would for an NX.
Because you're working with like PS3 graphics or something like that.
Yeah, exactly.
Also,
even less.
It doesn't use tablet. Like, at all.
At all. You can switch to playing on the tablet.
I wonder if the NX is actually
a
tablet.
I was playing the game and it looks like Link has a little tablet that looks like the...
He has an iPad, essentially.
I love this. Damn, Sea of Thieves looks good for a game of Play-Doh graphics.
Exactly. But that's what Rare is like good at.
Yeah, that's what
the graphics don't have to be like on point, but as long as the gameplay is solid,
as long as people are laughing and having a good time,
that's
what they care about. Mm-hmm.
And I'm curious about that because I've never played much of a Rare game, so. I played a little bit of Conker's Bad Fur Day and a little bit of GoldenEye.
Love that game.
That's all I ever
Conker's really, really good.
Banjo-Kazooie is one.
All but the Twilight Princess and have a version for that next Wii U.
Probably. They just came out
It was cool that if you put that Wolf Amiibo on the...
That is pretty cool.
That is so cool. Oh, also, I want that Link Amiibo where he's on the horse and the hood.
That's awesome.
Did you see any pictures of
them? I've seen
that.
Okay, it's so good.
It looks like Strider from Lord of the Rings.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, I'm done collecting Amiibos for the most part.
Yeah.
But I would get that one.
They had like a crap load of Amiibos at the thing. And then they had, I don't know if they were there or not, but they had Series 2 of the Mario Brothers.
You mean the big blow up of Waluigi being an Amiibo finally?
Yeah, Wario. They have a Wario making muscles.
I would actually like that too, GLJVD. I love a handheld with Wii U capability to shrink it from the normal size to a little smaller.
Mm-hmm.
I think that'd be cool. Oh, if the NX was what rumored to be, it was like a controller that was like
with
portable, you could just take it around.
Yeah.
The another rumor is that it's a platform, so it's not actually. Like, you can play it on a system, but you can also stream it to smart TVs and other systems, things like that. So
I can't wait to see the controller, because Nintendo always innovates what controllers are meant to be. They set the standard, and then other people copy them.
I think they need to move.
They do that.
People stop copying them.
They do that, and they don't at the same time, because, I mean, the GameCube controller was the best controller for Smash Brothers.
Exactly. That's why they brought it back.
On the GameCube, it was the best controller. Otherwise, it's a piece of shit.
Wow. Alex.
Our best friend Alex. What's up?
God, everyone's coming back. We're back.
You guys.
Look at that.
Guess who's back?
We're talking
E3. Sorry we've been gone for so long, guys. We'll try not to do that ever again, though.
Mm-hmm. We'll see.
We'll see. No, we'll try.
Generation drops the process thing.
We'll definitely do this.
They probably could. I think that'd be interesting. I'm not sure if Nintendo's going to do it, but I think that'd be interesting if they did do that.
That would.
Do the portable and you can bring it around anywhere. Yeah, we're talking E3 right now.
Talking E3 with everybody.
Yeah, because me, Nigel, and Pete all went to E3.
Let's talk about food at E3.
Exactly.
It was really shitty. No, I'm joking.
It was okay.
We actually had really good
food. The had a protein.
Did you do the Mafia 3 tweet thing?
No, I didn't do that. I didn't do the Gator.
They had jambalaya, too.
After what happened to that kid in Florida, there's no way I could eat an alligator.
What do you mean?
That's how you get back at it. Yeah. You get back at it.
I'm being dramatic.
It's for a land.
We ate... That gator was really good.
There was a lot of cool events that I didn't go through. There was some outside concerts.
Yeah.
A lot of comedians were there.
A lot of everyone.
Eric Andre, I don't know if you guys know who he is.
No.
He was there. He's a crazy guy. He was there. They had like a lot of rooms, different like.
I really like the Ubisoft stage where like randomly or every so often they would open something up.
Something was happening.
Yeah, and yeah. People would do like Just great. Dance on there.
Yeah.
That was crazy.
Because they had VR food there, right?
Like, they had VR food.
But like speaking of the gator we had with Mafia 3, they went all out for Mafia 3. Like that whole, they made a little like street for it.
Well, Resident Evil had a house
yeah.
with real dirt
yeah.
and weeds yeah. around it.
Yeah, I know.
I've seen footage of
these boots were unlike anything I've ever seen.
They were crazy.
They poured millions.
Square Enix had like a huge 2-inch screens.
Yeah.
They had a big band at Mafia.
Yeah, like
yeah,
a live band.
Live
and
band.
They walked around the whole
and, fortune tellers table. At each table.
And yeah. fortune tellers. Like, this is amazing.
It was basically a...
it's a marketing event.
I would say like a it had like a Louisiana vibe,
yeah.
I guess.
Yeah, that's what they're going for. Because their new game is in New Orleans.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
They had that vibe going.
Yeah. And then the Zelda area was amazing.
Huge.
It was huge. And they basically made Hyrule in this little
You
place.
Had to.
Hyrule
you actually,
was huge.
Oh, it was
I don't
amazing.
Know if you could
oh,
just
man.
Get in line just to go in and see it and
you
not
could.
Play.
You could.
Okay, but you didn't
yeah.
get the
stuff. You didn't get the
stuff.
Yeah, you didn't get any
okay.
stuff.
But like they had this, they were giving out this blue shirt. And a coin.
And a coin.
And the coin was like going for like 200, I heard on
it's
eBay.
Crazy
yeah.
now. Look it up on eBay.
It's
Zelda
E3. It's just a coin.
It's just
it says Zelda
man.
On it. And then like it has the eyeball on the other side.
Yeah,
yeah it's going to go.
But it's limited edition.
Nothing special.
It's limited edition.
It's a limited edition. E3 only.
You go on get
limited edition.
Play game at E3.
Coinage. They're trying to take my coins.
Coin the term.
Yeah, people will buy anything Legend.
People
Zelda.
Will buy it.
Well,
yeah.
any swag at E3, I think, was crazy. Those cat ears that people were running
oh,
around with from Persona 5.
Oh, I didn't see them.
I wanted
yeah,
that damn hat.
The cat ears?
But they couldn't talk with you in studios
want.
Having Norman Reedus in person getting a C-section.
They had Tekken had hats.
By the way, that game was so far away.
That is so far. Because that was probably...
I didn't get my hat, man.
Yeah, the
yeah.
hats were hard to
get.
Really?
Did
he take the hat?
No, he didn't get it.
I'm sorry.
I was set.
I would have got one for you. If
I was going
to
ask you guys.
I tried so hard to get that stupid hat.
you just take a picture with
Persona.
The
second. I know, but they ran out.
What if FurryCon took place in a section of E3? Would it be
Furry
the very... Oh, God.
I know what furries are, and I wouldn't, like, no, absolutely
no.
not.
No, some kid annoying
I wouldn't
me with
go
that in my store.
I stay away. Capcom didn't really have that much of them. They had that Monster Hunter balloon.
I wish Capcom...
I could talk about Monster
Hunter. They had a bunch of Street Fighter.
They had Street Fighter. They
yeah.
had Dead Rising.
Oh, you're right. They had the house. They had the house, you're right.
Yeah.
They had the house, and they had a giant Monster Hunter balloon.
Yeah.
Yeah. Bunch of
I guess the
stuff.
Best announcement was the Resident Evil 7, mostly.
That
yeah.
was the biggest
yeah,
that was the biggest announcement.
One.
They didn't even show Monster Hunter.
And if you guys haven't, you need
you
to
get
go
demo.
Download
yeah.
the Resident Evil 7 demo.
Play. Yeah, that's
on
yeah.
PlayStation Plus. Mostly.
On PlayStation Plus. It's free.
Yeah.
Is it only on PlayStation? It's not on Xbox?
I don't think
no.
so.
I think it's PlayStation exclusive.
Yeah.
I don't think the game is an exclusive.
No, no, but the demo,
yeah.
I think.
The demo is exclusive.
Yeah. Time exclusive.
So, big ups to every PlayStation player.
yeah. What else? I'm trying to think.
What was disappointing?
It's hard to cram.
What was disappointing?
What was disappointing?
Yeah.
Dead Rising 4. I didn't. Why?
I didn't see any previews.
I didn't see anything.
I played it.
I saw it.
I played it, and it's
like it looks like 3.
Like, you shoot fireworks, and they blow up like 50 zombies at a time.
I seen that. It looks
like
3. Yeah.
It's same thing. Right?
Like, why would I pick it up?
Yeah,
I don't know.
Yeah,
if you're invested in the series,
I even gave the kid a chance to tell me, you know, make me interested in it. Like, I'm like, is it a prequel? Is it a sequel? You know, it's part 4. He's like, it's Frank.
Yeah.
You still take pictures, which I find annoying.
Somebody's excited
for Dead Rising 4.
Yeah,
GLJVD.
Well, you enjoy that, my friend, because like
Dead Rising 4, I keep hearing
it's
a remake. I'm not
That's
sure
it.
About that.
I didn't like it.
I don't
like,
think
I,
it's a remake.
I think
it's a remake either.
No.
Didn't Konami announce a new pachinko game? Yeah.
Maybe.
What the hell?
Yeah,
games.
you drop the things mm-hmm. into Norman Reedus's gut.
The best, the best thing. I don't know. Maybe I'm a weird gamer. I don't like Zelda either. So.
You are
well.
Weird.
To be honest,
I can't listen to.
I've never gotten into the Dead Rising franchise, so
I never have either. But
Where was that Microsoft game where you're the superhero and you jump from building to building? And
oh, Crackdown!
I heard they were making another Crackdown.
I wanted to play that.
Where was that Crackdown?
That was two E3s ago already.
Yeah. Where was Crackdown? I'm interested in Crackdown.
I am too. Yeah.
I think it's supposed to be next year.
Well, they should have showed
the demo. No Crackdown, dude.
It's supposed to be working with like their cloud computing. Yeah,
they're delayed until next year.
Yeah, it wasn't.
Yeah, but like, show me something.
Right? I want to see it because the destruction
is real.
You can shoot a building and the building's falling and you're running through the building trying to get out of the building and you have to jump to another building.
And right? 4-player co-op.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Yeah.
Well, another game.
Rumor has it.
I think it's going to be earlier than Scorpio. I think Crackdown's going to be earlier than Scorpio.
I need some Crackdown, dude. That game was awesome, bro.
Yeah.
Like, once you get the jump ability, you don't even need the car at that point. Because you can just jump from, like, here to there.
Crackdown?
Yeah.
Probably another interesting game I was looking forward to. It's Titanfall 2.
Titanfall 2 was pretty cool.
Yeah, it was okay. It felt like Titanfall 1 with grappling hooks. So it's like Attack on Titanfall.
Yeah, mostly.
I like that. Attack on Titanfall.
But now that it finally has like a single campaign mode, I'm interested in seeing the story.
That could be interesting.
And finally, it's on PS4.
Oh, yeah. That's true.
So I'm actually part of the minority, I think. I think Titanfall 2 shouldn't have had a campaign.
No?
Yeah.
No. Have you played Titanfall 1?
One was missing.
So I have, but what I think Titanfall 1 was missing was content, not a campaign.
But they
have more content.
They caught up in content eventually with Titanfall 1, but it was too late.
Yeah,
was
I think if they released with all of that content,
it would have been good.
It would have been fine. Without a campaign. Yeah.
I mean, the game is still good. It's just, you know.
Yeah. I think if they did that with...
Why didn't they announce...
I think they did that with Titanfall 2 and just did a shit ton of multiplayer stuff in there. No campaign. I think it would have been an amazing game.
Why didn't they announce the new Tomb Raider for the PS4 yet?
They don't need to announce it. It just comes out whenever.
I did hear that they have 5 new characters for Overwatch, and then they have each character has a level they're gonna come out with.
Yeah, they're gonna make new levels.
You didn't hear that?
Nope.
I heard that.
New heroes and
he went to Blizzard.
you're the mecca of Overwatch. You're not asking questions.
I didn't speak to developers.
I would kick the door down. No, sorry. Whoa. How is Blizzard like? Come on.
Blizzard is like a dream
come true. No, say that experience.
Like, right like, to hell retribution to too.
Are you joking? Are you being serious?
What?
Are you joking about Blizzard? Or are you
what do you mean am I joking about Blizzard?
You said it was like amazing, the mecca. Like, was it really
it's beautiful there.
So it's in,
people
it's
are happy.
It's in California?
Yeah. California, where
of course
we were.
It's in California.
So, explain the experience of going to Blizzard.
I can't.
Explain it.
It's confidential.
Signing in is signing an NDA.
Oh, you can't say what you saw or what you experienced or anything like that?
Not really.
That's crazy.
Damn, my Diablo questions.
Oh my god.
I mean, I can say they have a museum there, like off of the side of their lobby.
You see the Overwatch toys?
The NECA ones that just came out. They're like 6 scale, and they have...
No, they like the giant ones.
They don't have those there.
I thought those would be at E3. I was a little bit disappointed about that. I thought they would be out front at E3.
But Blizzard doesn't go E3.
Blizzard didn't have a
thing.
They have their own thing.
Yeah, they have
BlizzCon.
That's it.
Oh, okay.
BlizzCon, actually, they have statues there of like their huge characters of each title that
Where
they do.
Where does BlizzCon held?
Anaheim.
Okay.
So it's still that around that area. But I saw the statues inside their offices for like Tyrael, Kerrigan, who else was there?
Can you confirm they have bathrooms?
I can't even confirm that. I didn't go to, they have a gym.
They literally have a bathroom.
I saw a gym.
There's a gym? Starbucks?
No.
Okay.
There's a volleyball.
There's a lot of people.
There were like a million Starbucks.
EA has
a
Starbucks.
Who cares?
I'm just saying.
Who cares? Beachbody has a shakeista instead of a barista.
That's pretty cool.
That was actually pretty cool.
That's awesome.
And they make a shake for you. That was awesome.
Yeah.
It's weird that all these places are there. Like,
it's California. Yeah.
There's so much. It's weird though.
Yeah, I've never been to any of them.
But yeah, Blizzard was beautiful. And I got some Blizzard gear.
Well, I want to.
Do they have a Blizzard store?
There?
Like,
no, why would... You work at Blizzard, why would you buy...
So LucasArts has a Star Wars store on there.
But do they have, like, public tours?
I don't know.
Probably.
If they have
a store like that, they probably do.
They have a store. Nintendo has a store on there. Because
they have public tours.
Because to do a tour at Blizzard, you have to, like, email them, so it's not, like, officially...
Time?
Yeah.
Okay.
I just have a connection, so I was able to.
Of course you do.
Wait
did the name drop?
I didn't drop any names.
He
that's why.
Name. He didn't drop
he said
a name.
Connection.
Connection's a name.
Connection's a connection.
First name Con, last name Action.
Mr.
Connection.
But
that's cool. I'm glad you... Is that something you wanted to do?
Yeah.
Okay,
cool.
Wanted
to
do
that.
Uh-huh. You would have gone there.
Someone kidnapped you and you had to go? Like,
we were at Disneyland. And
I left to go there to take the tour and then came back.
That's awesome, dude.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
It was really good.
That's good, man.
Anyone else want to talk more stuff about E3?
Yeah.
We were talking about things we didn't like at E3.
Yeah,
The lines.
That snowboarding game, whatever.
Oh,
Steep?
Steep, there you go.
No, I like the game where you fly, like in the box.
Yeah, with the
skills.
It's nonsense. I mean, what do you really want to do?
It's not for us.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe for whoever.
And there's no game out there like Tony Hawk failed, so no one's playing.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
There's no more SSX.
As I call it, Toby Han. Basically.
So there's no one catering to that audience, and Steep. You know,
if I wanted to play a snowboarding game, I'd download 1080 Avalanche on the Wii U.
Well, there you go.
It's the best snowboarding game that they've
ever done. 1080
Avalanche. I'd say SSX is good too.
SSX tricky.
SSX
tricky.
I don't
tricky.
Know, 1080. Have you ever
played well,
SSX?
Best.
SSX 3
Everybody's
was pretty good too.
Snowboarding game.
SSX 3 was really good too.
Anyone's playing Mirror's Edge 2?
Yeah, I played that at PAX
that
East. I didn't play it at E3 because I don't think it was there.
How is it?
It's out now, so why would it be at E3?
It's out. It's out. I don't like the teleporter at E3 that basically clones you, meaning your old self is vaporized. No. Any of you getting
No Man's Sky
was No Man's Sky.
No Man's Sky was not there.
Isn't that from
Probably
Insomniac?
Probably a good idea, to be honest. It's not from Insomniac. That's from an indie studio.
I heard that they're making a VR version of No Man's Sky.
Is that why it got delayed?
I don't think it's been announced.
I heard that
that was true.
Again, rumor mill.
I think that's a rumor. Yeah,
rumor mill. I'm starting it right now. This rumor. No.
It releases like
August.
Next month.
Start it now.
August. Yeah.
Anyone getting the collector's edition of Nominsky?
No.
Nominsky.
Wait, there's a collector's edition?
Yeah.
It's
you get the ship.
The ship. Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
It's the X-wing.
You get the ship.
That's cool.
It looks like the Star Wars.
I'll look at it after this. I'll see if I want it.
It's like an Elite Dangerous.
Attack on Titan game, anyone? No, I did not play an Attack on Titan game.
Was
that even
there?
Game,
actually.
It was there.
It was upstairs with the
Bandai.
It was
upstairs with
the
Namco,
yeah. Bandai was hidden for
some
reason.
We did play Tekken, where Nigel got his ass kicked.
Yeah,
let's
talk about
Tekken.
We're not talking
Tekken.
About that.
You want to talk about Tekken?
Yeah, let's
talk
about
Tekken.
We're not talking about Tekken.
Let's talk about Tekken.
I played Steve Fox. He played... Who did you play?
No one. I didn't play it.
I didn't play it.
Didn't
law
go
got
injury,
his, he played law.
He laid the law and he got
the
law was broken.
The
Such
law
a
was
low
broken.
Character.
I fought the law and the law.
Greg broke the law.
Whatever.
I fought the law
and the law.
And
so Bob says he played Nomansky. An early early alpha.
Was he at E3?
No. Super alpha.
Where? How?
Yeah, how?
Who's
Tell
he
us,
now?
Bob. Who do you know? Give us your contacts.
He knows connections.
We want them.
This is an interrogation. That's why the lighting's like this.
Yes. There's a lot of, I don't know how you guys are out in our, what is this, Twitchiverse. But there's a lot of betas and alphas.
You're missing a very easy thing to say. Our realm.
Oh, yeah, in the realm. but there's a lot of betas and alphas out there that you guys can sign up for that... These guys know about.
I just mentioned the experience PlayStation thing earlier, where you can experience standing in line to wait for VR, or you can actually play VR maybe, depending on where you are. That's going on. If you go to experienceplaystation.com, you can see where.
Yes.
Fair enough, Bob.
But I'm talking about like most like
NBA.
I'm talking about those betas that you guys are like.
I actually signed an NDA for my job, but...
Oh, that you're not supposed to talk about it?
I'm supposed to talk about certain things that we do.
There's another one that's Lawbreakers.
Oh, Lawbreakers.
Yeah, you signed up for the beta for that.
I didn't sign up for that one, because I heard that's cool.
Yeah, Ice-T was the voice on that, and his narrative.
Of course, because him and Cliffy B are like...
Cliffy B.
Yeah, exactly.
I didn't say who said it.
I thought that's other stuff.
I mean, Ice Cube's still cool.
I saw Cliffy B there actually with his wife, and they're trying to be really like they were walking through the crowd, trying to be like really. I don't know.
Oh, don't look at us. Don't look at us.
They had like their sunglasses on, trying to blend in. I'm like, yeah. I know who you are.
You know, I saw not at this AG, but AG Pride, and he had bodyguard. He had two Samoan bodyguards.
Who? The Rock?
The Rock had two Samoan bodyguards.
No,
the guy who made the Asian dude that makes Ninja Gaiden, he had like the super long hair. I know.
The guy who did that recent
Wii U flop,
The Devil's
Third.
That dude. Yeah.
What a piece of shit that was.
Yeah, nice and high.
That looks like a Wii game. Then
that guy was—he was walking through E3. He had shades on, hair long, and like
you guys
he didn't want to see the disappointment voice.
How did you play this game?
That was more of a Kratos there.
That was Kratos.
Come boy.
Was Kratos.
So Kojima's new game, what's it called?
Death Stranding.
Death Stranding. Yeah, Death Stranding.
Death Stranding, one of those.
Yeah, that's a...
That game's way fucking, like, that's 2020.
Yeah.
Like,
the graphics
is it, is it a Metal Gear?
No. It can't be.
It can't be, yeah.
Well,
it'll probably be... It's a naked... Overeaters and a naked baby game.
It'll be a Silent Hills-ish, if anything.
It looks like.
Maybe.
Because they were working on something, what, PT?
Yeah,
it's not the same developer, I know that.
But the trailer that they used probably was mostly assets from
that. Yeah. Naked dude, pretty much. Yeah, it's just going to be naked Norman Reedus on a beach.
Yeah, pretty much.
Naked Daryl.
Pretty much. Naked Daryl.
He dies in Walking Dead, and then this is his dream sequel.
I'm pretty sure he's dead.
I'm pretty sure.
We were discussing this too. We're pretty sure he's
died already.
Do you guys?
No, we don't know.
Not yet.
Do you guys care about? Do you care about Lego?
That was
worlds?
A long debate.
No, not too much.
No.
Yeah.
I got slapped. You think that's?
Yeah.
You think that's? Yeah, good?
I know. I can talk about a little bit about Injustice 2 if you guys want to talk about Injustice 2.
You're right, Bob.
Let's talk about Injustice 2 then.
Let's talk about Injustice 2. Injustice 2 had 6 playable characters. It was Aquaman, Grodd, Red Lantern, Superman, and Batman.
I think Grodd is so OP. For real. Grodd is so OP.
The game for what I played, a lot of characters play the same, except they added like one extra move to them.
Yeah.
Which people are complaining that... So Max was complaining that he could do a 30-hit combo already with Batman from just...
From the same game.
So he was a little bit upset that he could pick up and learn Batman that quick.
Mm-hmm. Oh, because they got the almost the same mechanics.
It's almost the same mechanics. Like, they didn't change the
So what's the point in upgrading?
It's pretty much the same to me. I don't know. Yeah, he's right.
Were you talking about the costume upgrades?
No, what's the point in getting Injustice 2? Just for the
new
characters?
It's a new story, new characters.
I like the story for the last one, too.
I do like the way Nezahualcóyotl do their stories.
Lizarro numbers followed. I got numbers. It's like 070.
Plus, it doesn't look darkish now on the game. It doesn't look like
the graphics look amazing.
It's color pop now. Like,
yeah,
you get to see how colorful it is.
I don't like Supergirl's face.
I feel like it's there so they can make her look like Power Girl. That's not the final.
Yeah, I know. I understand it's not the final version. Like, look at King of Fighters, how much that's changed over the last
couple
years.
Well, but people had to complain.
I'm actually waiting for that.
No, I think it was still in development at the time.
What I love about Injustice is that they're hiring talent from all these shows.
Yeah.
They're going to have skins for the characters, and they'll have the actual, like, Grant will actually be Flash this time.
Oh, there
it
is.
That's
good.
That's good.
Well, you check out my channel. Sure.
Yeah, sure. After.
Injustice 2, I want to play as Alfred. You can't play as Alfred.
No, I want to play as Alfred.
That would be crazy.
What if a special move with Alfred comes and throws like hot tea on you? That would be amazing.
Did you see the rosters for the characters?
I did.
Because they were based off of real people.
What are you talking about?
There was like a Conan O'Brien guy there. There was Hillary Clinton. There was... They had silhouettes of real people in the characters.
Oh, I didn't know that. That's really funny.
Yeah, I saw a picture of it later.
And did they Photoshop the people in?
No, they took the picture that they used and they put it right next to it. So there's David Bowie on there. There's a bunch of different people.
So even if I tried to sit there and figure out what the character... Because I could see all that
stuff. Yeah, so the characters aren't real, of course. I'm not going to put David Bowie in a Mortal Kombat game.
No.
They could, but...
That'd be actually pretty funny.
I would. But, yeah. I think they're trolling people.
It's definitely a game I'm interested in. Not only did they announce Injustice, but they have another announcement coming out this week.
Links don't work, Lazaro.
What?
Links won't work.
Okay.
Yeah.
They're blocked.
They have another announcement for Mortal Kombat X, so I think they have another combo pack for MK. So they're not done with MK.
Still yet. Supporting
yeah.
it?
Yeah. Still supporting it.
Still supporting
it. Another combat pack?
Another
not,
combat
not
pack.
For PC, though. But,
yeah. No love for PC.
No love for PC.
So let me tell you something. So Ed Boon retweeted one of my tweets one day, right?
Yeah.
So because he did that, when someone writes him something,
uh-huh.
I get to see what people write him.
Right. Yeah.
And there are so many people that want... the character for PC, and they do the way they ask him is like in a trolly way.
Well, yeah,
if that makes sense.
That's the internet, yeah.
Yeah. I got to see what he sees, and it's like really bad. Like,
I'm sure.
I couldn't deal with that.
I'm sure.
The more followers you have, the worse it is.
It's horrible.
Yeah.
Anything else in the gaming universe? Any E3 stuff?
I'm going over the show floor. NBA 2K17, WWE 2K17.
Yeah.
They weren't playable, but they were there.
Yeah.
Okay.
What else was there?
I mean,
Kingdom Hearts 2.8.
The press conferences
2.8,
were awesome.
Yeah.
The Sony press conference is awesome.
Best one.
How about Final Fantasy 15?
Final Fantasy 15?
Not impressive at the show, at least.
Yeah.
That boss fight was kind of...
Nah.
We fought that they could grab.
That's because it's an E3 like demo.
Okay.
So they specialized it just for E3.
Xenoverse 2
for Dragon Ball.
It wasn't playable. They had a video upstairs playing on loop.
They had ads up too for it.
Yes.
Like, between the two halls.
That was really cool. I took a picture in front of one.
Please, the Microsoft. No, it was not.
No.
Wait, what happened?
I disagree. Because Gears 4 looks like crap to me. Like, I really don't think
PlayStation,
Gears 4 looks good.
PlayStation, obviously. Well, Sony obviously took it as
well.
Play
Anywhere,
Xbox
One X, Custom Control. I mean, they all have their good point.
I like the Microsoft conference, but
yeah.
I like the Sony one more
because
it spoke more to me. Like, I saw God of War, I saw Detroit, mm-hmm. I saw Horizon, I saw...
that's another one, Detroit.
Detroit looks amazing.
Detroit does look amazing. What was the other game with the mimes or the clown people? No...
Oh, you're talking
no
about the one with the...
Cry.
Oh, We Happy Few?
We Happy Few.
That's a strange...
So, I saw that game being played.
That's a strange game.
Not a fan of what it looks like.
That's a strange
What'd you
game.
Say again?
It looks kind of We Happy Few. It looks kind of survival-ish.
But
is it narrative or
clowns?
It's like narrative, but like have you ever played like Don't Starve and things like that?
I played.
Where you have to get
Dawn
like.
I think you
like
get.
That.
I think you get two Goldbergs when you pre-order WWE 2K7.
Gilbert.
Anyone cringe with Minecraft? Yeah, Minecraft was cringe-worthy.
Like, yeah,
whoa,
well,
I got an
Sony
achievement
was,
on
Sony
Minecraft on my iPad. Whoa.
But you don't like Sony, so of course it's going to be boring.
Of course, you're a fanboy. Of course,
don't be biased like that. Everyone's entitled to whatever they like and they like.
The Sony one spoke more to me, because those games I actually want to play. Like, the only big game from Microsoft that I wanted to play was Sea of Thieves.
So you listed everything from Microsoft, and there's no games, Joe.
Yeah, there's no games there.
You have Play Everywhere.
So they were
that's
Xbox
what I'm excited
One,
about.
So they were
custom controllers.
So I already
yeah,
own it.
But
Xbox
no
One.
Games. Sony had games.
I already own an Xbox One. I already own a PS4. Don't try to sell me on more hardware. I don't need more.
Exactly.
I want games.
Yeah.
That's it.
And Gears 4, it was pretty lackluster.
Yeah, I didn't like that.
It looked like you, the Horde or whatever enemy that they're fighting could have been switched out with
it looked
the
yeah.
Locust.
It's a palette swap with Locust.
Yeah.
It looks
so
like
the same thing.
It looked like Krang.
Gears look like shit.
We talked about
Necro looks like shit.
Yo, Gears
we talked about all the games that are really
GLJBD, you should take a look at Recore. It looks like garbage.
CFDs.
But Recore could be good, but
I don't think it's going to be. Sea of Thieves looks good, which is the one game on the Microsoft press conference that I really
I actually
liked.
Want to say it. I actually want to play that. Yeah. Sea of Thieves is pretty good.
Oh, we forgot all about Bethesda.
We did
forget
all
yes. about Bethesda. Oh, yes. So,
Dishonored 2. Let's talk about Telltale. Walking Dead.
When Bethesda had a press conference, Telltale had Walking Dead.
Alright, so this is the greatest announcement I've seen from Bethesda.
Yeah, the Gears... Let me answer this. The Gears beta plays just like Gears of War 3.
Yeah.
Like, pretty much with the new weapon.
It had new weapons and that was it.
You could pick people up off the ground and shoot the back of their face off.
It played
the new assassination.
Like
yeah.
But yeah. Sure.
Alright, so Quake.
Yeah, Batman.
The new Quake. How do you feel about them?
I feel like it's taking away from their development or... their focus on Doom,
because
Doom's multiplayer is suffering, and then you see they're announcing Quake, and then it's like, oh,
almost like
that's why
yeah.
Doom is like dead in the water now.
That's why Doom is
focusing
Doom.
On.
They're
yeah.
focusing on Quake.
They're focusing on Quake.
Yeah. Well, Doom, they're doing the snap map thing, I think it's pretty cool, where you can like create your own maps.
Okay.
I don't know if you saw, someone made the Seinfeld house in Doom.
Yeah.
I've seen that, yeah.
It's fantastic.
It's so good.
I want to play that. I want to play the campaign for it, at least. But yeah, I'm not interested in Quake. As someone who's never played Quake before.
Yeah.
It's never spoke to me. I don't think it will now.
It's been years, too, that they developed that game.
Skyrim for current gen. So that's going to be cool.
Yeah, that's cool.
And the biggest thing is Prey. So Prey looks terrifying.
Yeah, Prey looks good.
It looks good.
From what we saw.
I love the trailer.
GLJBD said Bethesda announced...
that it is taking over the multiplayer for Doom instead of the third-party company that was in charge previous. Watch Dogs 2. That's Ubisoft.
That's Ubisoft.
I like Ubisoft's conference for the most part.
I actually still haven't watched Ubisoft's conference.
It's pretty good. Except for the end, because that's when they show off Steep.
Yeah, exactly.
Is that the Eagle game?
What?
Is that the Eagle game?
Steep is not the Eagle game.
That's
Steep.
The snowboarding game. Snowboarding.
The Eagle game wasn't that crazy either.
They played that Eagle sound way too much.
Infinite Warfare got 2 million dislikes. Yeah.
Yeah.
Two million dislikes.
But back to the Watch Dogs. Watch Dogs 2 looks really fun. I like the character.
Is it a multiplayer?
The best thing is that you can put your headsets.
But it's not all multiplayer.
The game.
Yeah, I like the headset thing.
Yeah,
he starts listening to Aaron
B
and Mark Kim. That was really cool.
A lot of people are complaining that the characters are black, and they're saying that the game is untrue to real life because black people don't know how to use technology like that.
Why did you bring that up now?
I think it's something important.
He wants to state it right now.
controversial.
I am the IT department at my job.
Hey, you don't have to use a cell phone like that.
Yeah, no, I don't know how to use a cell phone like that.
You can't hack a device with a cell phone.
Glad they're remastering Skyrim for current consoles. Glad to see Arnold Schwarzenegger and First Mater still getting work. Stacy mentioned Cuphead, and you might have missed me talking about it earlier. We did talk about Cuphead a bit. He likes it.
I love Cuphead.
You didn't play it.
I played.
It doesn't play nice.
These hands play Cuphead.
A new one. Seafinder Dory. Overruled.
What's that have to do with the game?
Nothing.
Moving on.
What were we talking about?
All right, so
we were talking about Bethesda.
Okay, yes. So the next one is they're showing a lot more of Dishonored 2.
Yeah.
Yes. So from there, I believe.
Did anyone play Dishonored 1?
Yeah, I played a little bit.
I played a bunch of it. I like it.
Isn't there another Thief as well?
No. That's the man.
I think Thief is done.
Thief is done already.
Teeth. No idea what the hell he was talking about. That's great.
Cuphead is played anywhere, by the way.
God,
it needs to be. Anyone a fan of Ron Jeremy?
Yeah, Cuphead.
I am a huge fan of
him. Cuphead's play anywhere. I'm not going to be playing it anywhere.
Oh. So sad.
I'll play it nowhere.
I'm going to wait. Sad moment.
Yeah, I'm going to wait for reviews to see if they fix that issue I was talking about. But
you said the channel link to Whisper?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Thief was trash.
So anything else?
No. I enjoyed my time with E3. I enjoyed talking to all the people and meeting our friends and.
It was a good E3 to go to. I think
it was.
It was an E3 filled with a lot of solid announcements, but nothing like major and surprising.
I think the E3 with the consoles are like the ones to go to.
So next year.
So is it next year?
Yeah, next year will be Scorpio.
Next year will be. I told you we weren't going to talk about it, didn't I?
Wait.
We're not going to talk about it. Overrule.
I wasn't going to talk about it.
No, but it wasn't there.
It wasn't there.
They didn't have anything for that.
The Neo wasn't there. None of the games were running on the Neo.
We could talk about it, but it wouldn't make sense. I was going to say, it wouldn't make sense.
It's not part of what we're talking about. So, no, we're not going to talk about it.
I didn't see it at E3, so.
It wasn't there.
All right. So let's start wrapping it up.
Sure.
That has nothing to do with anything. It's not there. We're talking about E3. We're done.
We're going to wrap this up. So E3 is a wrap officially. I don't think there's anything coming up.
Enjoyed being part of it.
Yeah,
I enjoyed being a part of it. It was amazing.
I enjoyed watching it.
He enjoyed watching it. I thoroughly
enjoyed being there. That is,
aren't you glad you went? Greg wasn't going to go, by the way.
I was so close to not going.
And it was last minute, and he went.
I'm, like, so close to banning GLJVD.
Listen, everyone's entitled to their opinion. Stop it.
Because he's a troll.
Stop it.
He's a troll.
Everyone's entitled to their
opinion. He's a troll.
Everyone's entitled to their opinion. All right, so we're going to sign off now, guys. We're going to try and do this again next week, same time. We're going to try and do it more frequently. We're going to try and stream more.
Yeah.
When we can.
But we'll definitely try be keeping up with the weekly.
Yes, this.
Our YouTube channel is Nerds Realm, right?
Yeah, as Nerds Realm.
Well, no, there's no / Nerds Realm. It's in the link below.
Everything's below the Twitch channel.
Don't forget to check out Steven's channel, which is...
Yes, of course. Basically, my website is gamerswithattitude.net. You could see my YouTube channel, Twitter, Twitch, anything.
Instagram.
So you can subscribe, like, anything. So they're all in there.
All right, guys.
Later, guys.
We'll see you next time.
Good seeing you.
Later, guys.
Peace out.
Game on. Sign me out.
Game on.
Get me out of here.